needs the help of allies, in particular the Netherlands, is because it is one of the areas where it has a company known as ASML, and that is one of China's main suppliers for these semiconductors. And so what they need is to have the Netherlands on board in order to not supply these semiconductors to China. Now, the Netherlands isn't quite sure it wants to work in this, so there's some dialogue that needs to take place. And China is saying, don't give in to the United States pressure on this. So there's some conversations that are taking place in the Oval Office right now surrounding this. And this is something that's going to have to be worked out. Obviously, there's a big financial incentive on the part of the Netherlands. They'd like to keep this arrangement going, but the United States says this is bigger than money. This is about security. So these are the kinds of conversations that are taking place at the White House right now. So that is a conversation that's still ongoing. We're watching this very carefully. Again, it's security that is on the mind of both of these leaders when it comes to China and Ukraine.
The testimonies that I hear on this news hour include cremations and the victims of Sunday's plane crash as the breach of the detained and carried away to Germany with climate activist Greta Thunberg from a protest site. And before, 10 degrees NFL season comes to an end in playoffs for a time again. Their economic crisis is causing widespread food shortages. The price of wheat has skyrocketed after floods destroyed crops last year, and the Ukraine war disrupted imports. Victoria Gates new reports.
Retailers are working within another bank scrambling to buy land of government subsidized flour. Inflation disproportionately affects the poorest in society. Across Pakistan, many are struggling with the rising cost of living. Soaring inflation is just one challenge. Pakistan is also facing a foreign exchange crisis. Workers are protesting outside a bank about a shortage of dollars. They can't get credit to pay for the goods they're importing. It means thousands of containers packed with essential food items, raw materials, and medical equipment are stuck in a port in Karachi. Importers who've been in the business for 35 years say they've never seen